Hello, welcome back. My name is Xander. This is a Python challenge called Word Frequency. To complete this challenge, you should write a program that counts the frequency of all words from a given input. So to paint the picture of what we're going to try and achieve here, we're using the terminal. So we're going to ask the user to type in a sentence. The user is going to type in a sentence, and then we're going to break that sentence down into individual words, and then we're going to count the frequency of every single word. So if the user was to type in helpful people are helpful, then it would return in the terminal helpful equals 2, it was used twice, and then r equals 1 and people equals 1. So that's going to be the outputs. That's what we're looking for here. Now, this can be done in many different ways. In this tutorial, we're going to show you how to utilize a dictionary to achieve this outcome. If you are new to Python and you're looking for a Python course, then you could go over to the playlist in the main channel and have a look at the Python course for beginners. Right, let's do this. So let's have a little think of what we need to do here. So we're going to ask the user to input something. So, well, let's just do this first. So let's say use sentence. Let's just use full words here. Sentence equals input. Now, this doesn't have to be a sentence, but we're just going to ask the user to type in something simple. Now, we could expand this to a function or other types of inputs. We're going to stick with a basic input. Now, this is a file called example.py. So we've already created this, and this is Visual Studio Code if you're not familiar with this IDE that I'm using here. Now, let's open up the terminal so you can drag or use a hotkey shortcut for that. So in the terminal then, assuming you've got Python installed, of course, I'm going to type in this, and then you can see at the moment it's blank. It's just waiting for you to type in something. That's what's happening at the moment. This is just an input. So let's say enter sentence. I'll do that. So just a little bit of instruction for the user. So just run this again. And you can now see we're prompted to enter a sentence. Okay, so that's the user input sorted. Okay, I'm on the Mac here, so I press Command and K just to clear that. Right, so next up, we probably want to now do something with this sentence. So we are going to be counting every single word. So what we're going to need to do is take every word, and we're going to need to split that up and put that into maybe some sort of storage. Okay, so let's loop through. We're going to iterate through. Remember, we're using string here, so we can iterate through each word that the user has typed in. So let's use a for loop for this. And then we're going to say for word in, and then sentence. So we're going to split this word up. So how do we do that? Well, if you remember, Python has the split function, which takes a string and puts it into a list where each word is a list item. So what we could do here is say dot split. So what we've done here then, we've iterated. So we're making an iteration. We're looping around this sentence that the user typed in. Remember, so what's happening here is that we're going to take this sentence, but we're using split. So what we're doing in actual fact is we're taking this sentence, which is one sentence at the moment, and we're splitting this up into a list. So what's happening here now is a list is being presented here. A list of the words that the users entered is now here, stored. So what's happening now, one by one, one item is going to come out of this list and go into Word, and we can then do something with it, maybe. So let's just print this out to see what's happening here. So let's just print out words. And remember what we're doing, again, just to reiterate, the user types in a sentence. That sentence is now stored in sentence. Okay, now what we're doing is we're going to loop that sentence, but first of all, we're going to split it. So we're going to take that sentence, split it up into individual words, save it in a list. That's what split does for us. And then we're going to take those words out one by one and loop through them. And then we're just going to print it out at the moment. So let's give that a go. So Python 3 and example.py. Okay, so let's say, hello, how are you? Okay. So that's this is the output. So remember, it was placed in a list, and then we loop through that list every single word, and every word gets placed then in a new row. Hello, how are you? So what we're going to do with this, we're going to store these words in a dictionary, and that's going to allow us to create a key value setup. The key is going to be the word. The value is going to represent how many times that word appears in the sentence that the user's entered. So let's do that. So freak. So we're going to say frequency equals, and then an empty dictionary. Okay, so that's that in place. So now what we can do is populate that with something. So we have all the words here, we split them up and we're looping through them. So let's go ahead now and take our dictionary frequency word. Okay, so let's just have a look at that. Again, if you're new to Python and you're looking through some examples, just take things step by step and try and get and better gauge what's happening just by having a look and just breaking things down a little bit and utilizing it a few more different prints. So what we can now do potentially is just print out this new dictionary we created here. So let's just give that a go. See what we got. Okay, so keyword error word. So it looks like we've got an issue here. So the reason why we've got an issue here, don't forget what we're trying to do is create an entry into our dictionary. Now remember, a dictionary requires a key value. So it should be something like that, for example. So it should say key value. So this is potentially why we're getting an issue here. So this is why currently we don't have anything stored in our dictionary. So we could assign a value. So let's go ahead and do that. So what we're doing now is we're storing a new entry into our dictionary, utilizing the word that's being passed in from our sentence split here, and then that's going to equal one. So that should, if we run that, it returns now a dictionary, and you can see that we have the initial word being passed across here in and equals one. So we could write a whole sentence. Now remember, every time this loops around, we're now storing a new item inside of our dictionary, and there we go. Right, so we've almost got the setup that we need here. We just need to work out how we're now going to count the words. So again, this all just comes down to understanding the tools that are available in the language. So what we have here is the get method, or what we're going to be utilizing here is the get method. And this returns the value for the specified key if the key is in the dictionary. So what we need to do here then is use get. So we're going to say, let's grab our existing dictionary here and use dot get. Okay, so get, like I just said, that is a method which returns the value for the specified key. Okay, so this takes in two parameters, which is the key, and then potentially a value. So there are two inputs here in this get function here. Now, the first is going to be the key name that we're trying to find in our dictionary here. So that is going to be provided by word. Remember, the word is being passed over to word and then utilized. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay. Now remember, here we're just working on the values. Let's not forget that. We saw in the previous example, this here is setting up the key in the dictionary here. This side, we're just working with the value, right? So if, for example, this get function here is trying to look into the dictionary here to find a key and then grab the value. Now, if that doesn't exist, what's going to happen here is we need to assign a value. So we can do that by passing in the second parameter here. So what's happening now is if we don't find the word in the dictionary, we're going to just use the value zero. So let's have a look at that in action. So if I just type in hello, we're past zero. Okay, so if I change that to one, just do that again. There we go. So you can see this is the default value if a value isn't found, because the key doesn't exist in the dictionary there. Right, so let's put that to zero. Okay, so we obviously don't want zero, and potentially we don't also want to use one, because what we want to be able to do is to be able to find if there is an existing key. And if there is an existing key, we want to do something with it. And that's obviously we want to increment that by one. So let's do that, plus one. So what we're going to do now then, by doing that, is we're now saying that if we find a word, if a word gets passed in and we find that word, if we find that word inside of our dictionary, then what we're going to do, we're not going to set the default value, is we're going to just plus one to it because we found a similar value. So let's put that into action. So if I just say hello. Okay, so obviously what's happening now is that it couldn't, went down to here. We iterate over the word hello. Obviously we set up the word, the key for the first entry. We can't find the value, so we set zero. That's what's happened so far. All right, so let's do that again. Hello, and then hello. So obviously what we have now is two words. So we're going to split that up. The first hello is going to go in, and then we're going to set that up. Hello, that's the key in our dictionary. And then we're going to set that to zero. Now we're going to iterate over the second hello. Now we set that up. Now obviously that already exists. This key already exists. So we're not going to overwrite it. Well, sorry, we're going to override it because it already exists. So we can't make two entries the same because it already exists. So what's going to happen now is we're going to grab the value of the word, which is hello, and then we're going to go ahead and get that value, and we're going to plus one to it, and that's going to increment it. So let's give that a go, and there we go. So we now have two. Let's remember that the key already exists, so we're not going to be making a new entry. However, this time in the second iteration, because there is already a value for this word, then we're going to grab that value, and we're not going to place the zero, and then we're going to grab that value that already exists, and then we're just going to plus one to it, therefore incrementing the value every time a word is matched or a key is matched inside of our dictionary. So let's take a look at that in action. So we can say, we're going to finish off by printing out frequency. So let's give that a go. So we're going to send hello and hello. And this time we now return hello and the value two. So what's happening here, the first hello, remember we split this up, the two hellos. So the first hello goes in and then there's no value. So it gets placed zero, gets assigned. And then the second hello goes in. Now hello already exists here, so we're not going to make a new entry. However, now get function finds that there's already a hello via this word here inside of our dictionary, therefore grabs that value and then we plus one. So that's really the mechanics here, or the logic that we're going to utilize to now print everything out back to the user. Now it could be useful for us to actually grab these words inside of our dictionary and then sort them into some sort of order. So let's just grab the keys from our dictionary here. Now you don't need to do it this way, I'm just breaking this down. And let's say words equals, let's use sorted. Now what sorted is going to do here is it's going to sort all the given elements. So in this case, we're going to grab all the keys and then we're going to sort them in alphabetical order in this case. So that will return the list, will return to the user the words in alphabetical order. Okay, so with that in place, we now need to loop through that. So for item in words, let's just loop through that, and we're just going to print out to the user the words and the values. So we're going to use an F string here. So let's just print out item, and then let's say inside equals, let's go for frequency item, So this is going to return the value. Remember, what we're doing here is we're looking inside of our dictionary, and we're saying item, remember that's the, we've sorted the keys. Now we're using the key name to then return the actual value here. So what's happening here is we've sorted the keys in our dictionary, and then we've then gone ahead and we've iterated through those keys. Obviously they are in alphabetical order this time. So we print out the key, and then we use the key to look inside of our dictionary to get the value. So we've got then the key name and then the value. Let's give this a go. So helpful. And there we go. So that was just one way of many ways for you to achieve this challenge. If you do happen to have any other crazy ways of achieving this challenge, then please leave them in the comments. It's always interesting for myself and everyone else to read. Just a big thank you to all the members and supporters of this channel. Thank you very much for your continuing support. If you would like to support us further or potentially join our members, you can do that by following the links from the main channel to the channel membership or potentially following us on Patreon. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you like and want to subscribe, of course, or else just follow us on our socials.